What's going on, fam? It's your boy Sneaker Junkie back at you with another quick tip trick tutorial. So this is actually part two of when to sell them and when to hold them. So I just shot a video and posted it 2 days ago. That was June 29th. Today is the first, and I was speaking on really supply and demand. And then obviously if there's, you know, less supply out there, then there's more demand for them, therefore the price will be higher. And on the flip side, if there's more supplies out there, then the demand will be lower, therefore, right, the price will be lower. So anywho, here we are 2 days later, July 1st, 2019, and we were speaking about the Jordan 1's Gym Red right here. So look at it. So when I shot the first video in this segment, in this series, when to sell them, when to hold them, my size 9.5 was teetering between 230 and 235. Here we are 2 days later. Look at that. Now we're up to really roughly 260. So before, if you go back and watch the video, there was a lot of for sale sneakers axe priced around 240. Look where we are now. See what I'm saying? So this is why it's key to hold your sneakers. Now, nobody can predict the market, whether the flows are up or down, but you can see the trend. So when that sneaker dropped this the 29th, that morning, Saturday morning, and I shot that video in the evening, so the sneakers dropped around 7, I'm on the West Coast, so sneakers dropped at 7 a.m. my time, and then 5 p.m. my time, last Saturday, they were around the same. So when they dropped, resale was about 230, 235, 7 in the morning, 5 p.m. that same day, they were still teetering between that same mark, that same price break. So that, for me, triggered in my mind, okay, these sneakers are going to rise. Just because if they're teetering the same price between 8 hours when they drop and at the end of the day in that 8 hour span, and they're roughly still the same, a couple dollars off here or there, they're definitely going to rise in price. So right now, the highest axe is 259, and then you have 20 axe at 260. So this is what I'm predicting again. Sit on them. This 260 may come down. That's just the way the market is, right? But if you sit on them, I the first time I said sit on them a week, but here we are 2 days later, right? Making a second video. Sit on them for another week. And I'm hoping we can get to, look at this, 275. It's a stretch, but you just don't know what the market's gonna do. So I'm gonna sit on mine. I have 2 pair, 9.5. My buddy had he had a size, I think he had size 8. And look at that, that's bananas, man. So obviously you can see the dip there, but you just don't know. So here we are again, I keep doing that. 2 days later, the shoes dropped Saturday, June 29th. Here we are July 1st, and we're up another almost $30. So just to prove the theory that I had, again, I'm no expert. I don't have a magic ball, crystal ball. Nobody can really predict the highs and the lows and the flows of any stock. Because this is nothing but stocks. So nobody can predict it, but you can look at the trends. Again, if the shoe drops at 7 a.m., resale was between 230 and 240, 7 a.m., then that same day at 5 p.m., and we're still in the same price break, the same price margin, it's a good chance that sneaker's gonna go up. And sure enough, here we are, right? So I'm gonna predict, if you hold your shoes for a week, today's Monday, well, hold on for just this week, this Friday. Let's see. I'm curious to see how far we can get between today, Monday, July 1st, and Friday, July 5th. I'm hoping we can get up to this 275. That is a bit of a stretch, but you just don't know. So I'm gonna say sit on them until this Friday. Obviously, watch the market. It's totally up to you. I like to sit on mine for a while, only because I still have, you know, Foot Locker's 45 days to return them, get a full refund. So I can sit on shoes close to 30 days. I mean, if it goes up, great. If not, you know, I'm a reseller. I like to make a little bit of a profit on them. But if not, I can always return them and get my full refund. Now if the shoe starts to dip, you know, obviously as you get close to, you know, retail, then obviously it's time to sell. But watch the market, keep your eyes on it. But again, you just don't know, but you have to watch. So anywho, it's your boy Sneaker Junkie, part two of when to sell them and when to hold them. So I'm predicting if you hold them till Friday, July 5th, I'm gonna hold them till July 5th, obviously, but I'm gonna predict we'll at least get to this 260 for sure. It's not that many between 258 and 260. I would like to see us get to 275, but I think we'll get somewhere between, I think we'll get to about 270 by Friday for sure, July 5th. So anywho, it's your boy Sneaker Junkie. Do your thing, watch the market. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. If you have any questions, maybe something you want to see in the future, maybe questions you have, or demonstrations, or more tutorials on a certain topic, yo, hit me up, DM me. Follow me on Instagram at sneakers_junkie, and do your thing. So it's your boy, Sneaker Junkie. I'm out of here, folks. Do your thing. Later.